Back to one of Fox top stories today. President Trump issuing an emergency order grounding Boeing 737 MAX jets after saying he got new information on Sunday's Ethiopian Airlines crash. Joining me now, retired commercial airline captain J.P. Tristani. So good to see you. And I want to give a little bit of your resume that is relevant to this. You were a U.S. Naval test pilot, 43 years of worldwide flying operational experience, and you're now an aviation consultant. What can you tell me about grounding the MAX 8, MAX 9 jets, and was there the necessity earlier on to do this?
No, there was no necessity early on to do it, and there is no necessity now to do it.
Really?
I feel that President Trump acted prematurely and, in fact, slapped the face of Boeing, American Airlines, Southwest Airlines, and every pilot flying the line on that aircraft. It was needless. And he answered to a fear quotient that was going out from foreign carriers.
Well, all right, but that fear quotient is real. We've seen two crashes, one deadly on Sunday in the last 5 months. You are the only person that I've heard say this, and I'm very curious to know, what is it about this jet that you would say that for when Lebanon, Egypt, I mean, there are countries all over the world that have grounded this jet.
I also spent 9 years in service of foreign airlines. And I also went through their simulator training. So, and these were not top-tier airlines, not Air France, British Airways. These were the subs of what you're talking about, Lion Air and also Ethiopian Air. Mm-hmm. They're not major carriers. So I look at the training. What was the training that those particular people had? Now, you want a database on what I object to the grounding? I've got an aircraft company of the major size of Southwest Airlines operating an aircraft since May 2017, 88,000 hours in the air, 41,000 takeoff and landings. And now you're telling me that in all this time, with that many cycles on takeoff, where these two crashes have the same problem that they were on takeoff, and nothing showed up on Southwest Airlines in all these years, or American Airlines.
So then I press on with what we're learning, the handful or more of pilots who've come out and their complaints have been surfacing, that they had similar complaints about this particular jet in recent years. I mean, would you take a chance and not ground them at this point? Would you stand alone as the United States and not ground them?
I not only would stand alone, but as a pilot, I would gladly fly that aircraft tomorrow.
Well, a lot of pilots don't agree with you.
Well, these pilots that you're talking about, the four American pilots who rode up the aircraft on takeoff for a sudden nose down, two anonymous ones, who were they, Ivan and Vladimir, that put out this bulletin? There are places that you go when you have problems with your aircraft, and one of them is the maintenance log. So when these pilots landed, what they experienced in flight, those four pilots, that's all. What they rode up in there was the maintenance problem corrected, because if they took an airplane out that they knew to be unsafe, then they violated an FAR themselves. And there are avenues for any pilot flying on any line to make his fears known to both the company without retribution.
What do you think about the reporting? And the president mentioned this. I was recently with the White House press secretary, Sarah Sanders. I asked her about it as well. I've talked with military pilots, retired, who have said that we have gotten to the point where software is alienating the pilot's ability to really connect with these machines in the sky, and that it's complicated. And then these particular jets, it's been reported that there were software issues with this, that not everybody was trained on what to do with a stall on some of these per this new software.
Well, it never got to the stall. The software that was put on only the MAX airplane, only the B737 MAX 8, going all the way back to 1967 when the B737-100 came out, this is just a modification due to the new engines. So it was not a new necessary criteria for the FAA to approve this particular model. And that software was just a stall prevention device.
So how do you answer, because I know you're going to get some, how are you going to answer your critics who say you stand alone with those 43 years of flying, former military, you look at all that's before you, why take a chance? Does it hurt or help Boeing to make a stall. I know they don't still own the planes, the airlines do, but they're also in a recall position. Their reputation is on the line. Why not take just a pause and get this right?
Because that's an easy way out. All I'd want to do is say, okay, let me see the simulator program that Southwest Airlines and American Airlines pilots went through. Let me see what you did with the immediate action item when that occurred on a flight in a simulator that tells me that you were trained to have that. And then I would go to these pilots that are overseas. Mm-hmm. Let me see their simulator training, because most of them contracted out. So did their simulator experience include when you get from a normal to an abnormal to an emergency checklist, mm-hmm. but precluding that emergency reading the checklist is an immediate action item. So did they have that demonstrated to them in the cockpit, in the simulator?
So and you're saying that whatever problem we might have with any plane in the future, it might be the international training of pilots that's
happening?
Better
believe it is.
Wow. J.P. Tristani, you're going to have an interesting day. Thank you for your perspective
on it. I can take that. Thank you very much for having me.
I think you can.